I'm going to show you how to collect the PI message logs. These are also often referred to as the PI SDK logs. PI interfaces, the PI Buffer Subsystem, and the PI Data Archive all write to these logs, so if your issue involves one of these components, you'll likely have to collect the PI message logs. This includes scenarios where you can't connect to the PI Data Archive, for example, using a PI visualization tool. If your issue involves a different component, such as the PI AF server, you might need to collect the Windows event logs instead. I'll show you how to do that in the next video. Before you start, you'll need the following. First, you need to figure out which computer to gather the logs from. This needs to be the computer where the application is installed. For example, to gather the messages posted by a PI interface, you'll need to log onto the computer where the PI interface is installed. Next, you need to decide the time range for which you'll be collecting the logs. Make sure that the time at which your issue occurred is included in the range you're collecting. For example, collect one day before and after the time of your issue. Let's do an example. Say you have a PI interface that stopped sending data at 1 p.m. on July 26th. Which computers will you collect the logs from? Well, of course, you'll collect the logs from the computer where the PI interface is installed. But the PI Data Archive logs might also collect information about your issue, so you'll want to collect the logs from that server as well. Next, we need to make sure to collect the logs from the right time range. Let's write out the start time and end time so we don't make any mistakes. I'm going to collect the logs from July 25th at 1 p.m. to July 27th at 1 p.m. It's common to make formatting mistakes while writing the time, so I would suggest using the following format, since it will always give you the expected result. Use the three-letter abbreviation for the month and write the time in the 24-hour clock, also known as military time. Here's my start time and end time in this format. Alright, let's get started. First, I'll log on to the computer where the PI interface is installed. I'll show you two methods of gathering these logs. First, using a command line utility called pigetmsg, then using the PI SDK utility. The pigetmsg command line utility is a great option, especially when you want to send these logs to someone else, like a tech support engineer. It's available on all computers with a PI message log, and can output the logs in multiple different file formats. The first step is to run the command prompt. So let's go to our start menu and type cmd. Make sure to right-click and select Run as Administrator. First, we'll want to navigate to the right directory. Type the following: cd space slash d space percent pi home percent backslash adm. This is the correct command for any computer that's not your PI Data Archive. If you're logged onto the PI Data Archive, make sure to write %PI Server% instead. Next, we'll use the utility to create a file that contains our messages. Type pigetmsg space dash st, and now we'll want to put our start time parameter. You'll want to put your start time in quotes. So start with quotes and then write the time in the format that we discussed previously. Next, you'll want to add your end time parameter, so dash et. Once again, make sure to put your timestamp in quotes. Finally, we want to specify our output file, so type dash of and put the name of your file in quotes. You'll want to give your file a meaningful name. At the end, put your file extension. You'll normally want to use the file extension .txt, and then close the file name with quotes. A tech support engineer might ask you for the logs in the raw PI message log format. In that case, type .dat instead as the file extension. After reviewing your command, go ahead and click Enter. If there were no messages contained in the log between your start time and your end time, you'll get an output that says no messages, so watch out for that. The final step is to open our file and make sure we've collected the right logs. To open the file location, simply type start space period. Here's our file, so let's open it up. And we can quickly confirm that we have collected the logs from the computer where the PI interface is installed, and that we have the correct start time and end time at the bottom. We can now copy this log onto a new computer, and if we want, send it to tech support. Now I'll show you how to use the PI SDK utility to view and export the message logs. This option is great, especially if you want to read and filter the logs locally while troubleshooting your issue on the machine. Note, however, that you can only export the logs in the CSV or TXT file formats, and that the files output from this utility are not as easy to read. Let's go to our Start menu and type PI SDK. You might find two applications, the 32 and 64-bit ones. It doesn't matter which one you choose. Under Tools, select Message Log. You'll want to add your start time and end time here. If your end time is now, you can leave the star in this field. If you're exporting these logs for tech support, make sure not to put any filters here, as they'll most likely want the raw logs. However, you will want to change the severity here. By default in the PI SDK utility, the severity is set to error. You'll want to make sure to change this to debug in order to gather all of the logs. You can now look through the logs, and if you're troubleshooting on your own, you can use the filters. If you want to export the logs, go ahead and click this button here. Once again, make sure to give your file a meaningful name. One last thing I want to show you is how to collect the PI message logs on the PI Data Archive without having to log on to the PI Data Archive server. To do this, you need PI System Management Tools installed on your computer. So let's open up that utility. Make sure that you're connected to the right PI Data Archive in the Servers pane at the top left. Navigate to Operation, and then Message Logs. Add your start time and end time in these fields here. To search, click on the magnifying glass here. To export the logs, click on this button. Make sure to select Export All. Once again, give your log a meaningful name. You'll want to make sure to indicate that these are the PI Data Archive logs. Once you've collected all the logs, you're ready to continue troubleshooting, and if necessary, get help from tech support.